So this problem, it is a slanted problem, okay? Slanted problem in pyramid, okay? So this problem, it is resting with the slanted. As we have discussed, if the position is resting with the slanted, means first position starts from the corner. If the position, if it is resting with the slant triangular face, means this. So first position has to start from this edge. So in this problem, it is resting with respect to the slanted. That's why it is starting from the corner here. So we will run the both the top view with this. Slant edges with the thick lines, and the front view of it is a triangle. Now in this second position, it is resting like this on the x1 line, okay? So on the line it is resting, that is making this slant edge c dash o dash resting on the x1 line, okay? Resting on the x1 line. This is how we do. Now by looking at this, we are going to draw the top view. So first we are going to draw an outer boundary line like this. Then after that, visible face, this base of the pyramid, it is visible, that's why continuous square here. And they see that this edge, it is visible, okay? That's why a dash to o dash continuous line. But this resting slant edge, this slant edge not visible, this slant edge. So that's why you can see that from c dash to o dash has to be dashed line. But there is already a continuous line from o dash to o, so that's why we are showing a part of the dashed line from here to here, okay? Now in this third position, it is resting like this. Okay, this is what the position in the third position. Same concept here. First, we are drawing in the base of the pyramid. Okay, base of the pyramid drawn. And then the slant edges. If the slant edges passing inside of this base, say this slant edge D dash O dash passing inside of the base, that's why it is written in dashed line. So these, it's from A dash to O dash, B dash to O dash, and C dash to O dash. It is passing outside. That's why it is written in continuous line. Okay, so this is how we visualize the pyramid problem with the slant edge.